as well, but I think that if I put it on, I'm going to look ridiculous. I'm going to do it anyway. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And the post lady just brought a package that I needed to play with today. Because she delivered this. The Layla 2 from Blush Tribe. And when you ordered this, you also got a free titanium dust. So I have that one as well. So let me show you the inside of the palette. It's cardboard, by the way, no mirror. It does come with a plastic sheet, but her palettes never have mirrors. Or at least the palettes that I have don't. I'm going to fold it back very, very carefully. Did I say what this palette was called? It's called a Layla 2. This is the color story. This shade, it does not really translate on camera the way I am seeing it. I can tell by my monitor. This is a neon-y green, but a light neon-y green. Does that make any sense? I don't know. But it is a combination of mattes and shimmers. You get three shimmers and the rest are mattes. It's a combination of, well, a little bit more, I don't know, forest-y greens or something. Then you have that pale. It's almost like a pastel neon green. It's really, really unique. Then a yellow. Here you get some more olive-y, mustardy color. So you have kind of everything, you know? The only thing you don't have in this shade is a very, very deep green. But yeah, that's actually the only shade I am missing. Is a very deep green. But yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and open this because I want to use this as well. I already did my base. I'm going to swatch the palette. And yeah, then I'm going to decide if I want to do a look or if I want to do it palette bingo style like I usually do. So let me kind of do that. See where I have the most room. I think it's here. So let me go and swatch her. I'm going to start here with the yellow one. And then I'm going to go like that row by row. It is on a... Well, my arm is clean, but no primer, nothing. So, just so you know. So here is the completed palette and you saw me build some shades up, especially the first row. That is also because I'm not the best at swatching and I really wanted to show the colors. Swatches don't say a lot. For me though, they kind of give me a feeling of the shades. Because I like to feel everything with my fingers. So they give me a feeling and they sometimes give me an idea on how to work with the shade, if that makes any sense. In my personal experience, Blush Tribe isn't the best at swatching, although the Paulina palette is maybe the best swatched that I have from Blush Tribe. But yeah, I cannot wait to dig in. And the shades feel nice, they feel creamy. And I did not expect actually this shade called Maria to show up immediately. Same as with the yellow, because those are shades that are notoriously hard to make. So yeah, let me go and try and open the titanium dust thingy as well. Never tried these. Okay, so it's... Oh, it's so cute. I don't remember. I think this was called Layla. But the name isn't on here, so I don't know exactly. Can I open it? Oh, yeah. Oh, it's so cute. It's so cute. Can you see? It's very tiny and it's very cute. It's actually cute because it's tiny. So yeah. So let me see if I can swatch it. I have no idea how to do that. I'm just going to dip my finger in. Let's put her here. No, let's put her here. Okay. So, oh wow. I do feel the particles. if you are darker than me, this will be an amazing highlight as well. But I think that if I put it on, I'm going to look ridiculous. I'm going to do it anyway. So I have a little bit in the cap. Let's do it. I don't know, this was a good idea. It's going to take forever to blend, probably. Let me get my mirror. Wow. It does blend out nicely on the face, to be honest. Wasn't really what I was going for today, though. But yeah, let's just work with it, you know? So now I have a glittery nose. I am going to tone it down just a tad. But yeah, so that is the titanium dust. I want to use it today as well. Now, I do have a mixing medium somewhere. So let me go and find it. Where did I put it? So I have a mixing medium here as well. And I think I need to use that with stuff like this. I think also use a wet brush in that. But yeah, I want to know what the shade Maria looks like on the eye. That is the pastel neony green. So I think I'm going to use that one and then we will see from there. So let me just prime my eyes real quick. If I can find my primer, my Essence Color Boost thingy primer. So yeah, this was one of the palettes that I was really, really excited for this year. Or at least as soon as I saw it release. And I'm on a really on a green kick lately. So if you are new to my channel, I will link some other green videos underneath the cards and such, because I also did a 6 looks with the Tasty Avocado palette from iHeart Revolution. And I have also been playing with the Just My Luck palette from Colourpop. That isn't on my channel yet, because other things kept taking, I don't know, precedence, you know? Okay, let me just get a dense brush. I'm going to start with the color Maria. And yeah, it is, I don't know how it will translate. I will see that in editing. I hope you can see what it looks like, but it's just such a pretty color. It's pretty dusty in the pan. Let's press it on and see how much I need to build it up, because I probably need to build it up. The lighter the base that you use underneath a shade like this, the better it will show up. I don't have a white base. I don't want a white base, to be quite honest. But as you can see, it does show up. It's light, but I wouldn't have expected any less. If you are darker than me, you need to treat it like a pastel. And that means a lighter base and use a tacky base. Also, remember that any base that you put underneath shades like this kind of affect the color of the eyeshadow as well. So if I were to use my MAC Paint Pot, for instance, I have the color Soft Ochre, which is yellowy. If I put this shade on top of that, it turns more yellow. Does that make any sense? So if you put a teal on top of a yellowy base, it pulls more green than blue. That's what I found recently. It shows up nicely though. I don't need to build it up. Again, I did not expect any less. So yeah, let's go with the next color that is kind of difficult to create usually. And that is the yellow, and it is called Asia. I hope I pronounced that right. Asia. That's how I would pronounce it anyway. So let's get that one just on the same brush I cleaned it in between. Let's see what this yellow does. Okay. So that is pretty pigmented right off the bat. Especially for yellow. I'm still tapping it on. It's a good yellow. Or at least as far as I can tell now. Now I do plan on doing multiple looks with this palette. Just so you know. And then here, I don't want to really blend, I'm just going to tap over. And I can already see that the colors mix nicely. So that is very, very good. Now, the brush that I have now is dense. It is a brush that you could blend with. It is just not a brush that I can blend with. So I use this to pack it on where I need to in small areas. Does that make any sense? And it says Zoeva on the brush, number 17. Very, very nice, guys. Okay, so now I have laid that color down. I want to blend a little bit. For that, I'm going to take my favorite detailed blending brush that I have. You can also use the Morphe M506 or 507 for that. But these are just, for me, even better to blend with. This is the shape. They're weird. They're kind of flattish, but also a bit fluffy. Not flimsy, because I have a flimsy brush here. I cannot blend with that. So yeah. I'm going to go into the color Maria first, which was the first shade. And I'm going to concentrate this on the edge. I don't really want it to higher. I just want it to blend. And then sometimes it is just easier to take a little bit of the color that you are blending out, because then it makes it easier to blend out, you know? And also, I don't really want to lose the vibrancy of this shade. And I think, because it is such a light shade, that if you blend too much, you will blend it away. I think. I'm not sure though, but that's my guess. I'm also going to go over it a little with extra on my brush, just to make sure it's not patchy. And it's nice and diffused. And distribute it and all that goodness. I'm going to go a little bit over the edge here. Okay, I'm going to go to the yellow, the Asia color. And my base is still a bit tacky here, so I'm going to press it on a little first and then blend. I have a hair there that is annoying the hell out of me, so let me get rid of it real quick. Thank you. Yes. I am dipping into the yellow constantly, just to make sure that I get a nice blend everywhere. Okay. Let's deepen it up a little bit. I think I want that color on the lid. Should I do crazy and not deepen it up? Let's do crazy first. So let's get the color Asia, which is the yellow, underneath the eye, at least in the outer corner. Actually bringing the yellow around underneath my eye. Also bringing it a little bit on my lid here. Usually I tend to deepen up a look in the outer corner. Maybe I shouldn't today. Just to spice it up, you know? With a different brush. A small brush. I don't know how it will show up, but we will try. I'm going to go in that color Maria, which was the first pastel-y green. And I'm actually going to place it here. I don't know if it will show up though. No, I don't think so. So the yellow color I'm putting here in the inner part of my lower lash line. Okay. Now for the shimmers. I want that one, yes. But I also want... Where did I put you? This one. Which is called Cerish, I think. So let me get a brush. Usually I use NYX Glitter Primer, but I'm actually not going to now, because I want to see what it does when I spray it and when I use it dry. So I have the color Cerish here, and that one is going to go on my eye, on the outer part, first, dry. Let's see what it does. Oh, this is a pretty color. Oh, that's gorgeous. Okay, now let's see what it does when I spray it. Yeah, it sticks a little bit more. It also looks to be a little bit more opaque when you spray it. So you can basically do either. So that is good to know. What I'm going to do is I'm going to connect it to my lower lash line. But for that I'm taking a different brush. Still the same color. I'm going to spray. I'm actually placing it higher here. so that I can see it when I look forward a little bit. Yeah, this is cute. Now I want the titanium dust on the inner part of my eye. I actually don't know if it will be opaque enough or that I need to put down the yellow as a base. I don't know. So let's just try something, shall we? I have here a tiny brush. Let's spray it first. So I have here a brush. I'm spraying it now first. It's a little bit differently than I would usually do. Then I'm going to go into the pigment with my brush. Tap also, I have quite a lot here actually. And I expect fallout. So yeah. I'm going to press it on my eye carefully. So that I can get the most particles off my brush, you know. And then I'm going to see if I can blend it. So it looks to be pretty sheer. I think, at least. I don't know. Picking up a little bit more. The fallout is actually okay. Yeah, I do have fallout, but it's actually okay. I'm going to go over the edge. Wiggle, wiggle. Into that greeny shimmer. Just a little to make sure that the edges are nice and blended. And I want it a little bit diagonally because I like that. Cute. Okay. I also want it underneath. How am I going to do that though? I'm going to grab a brush that is very tiny. So it's actually a lip brush. So I hope that I have some more control with that then. Okay. I don't think that brush is picking up anything, so that's not good. Okay, let's try a different brush. This is also a lip brush, but it picks up a little bit more. This one is, I don't know from where. So I do get massive fallout now though. Maybe I should have done my eyes first. But I don't think it would have mattered though, because this is a part that I do after I have done my face anyway. So yeah, I am going to go back in the color Cherish, which was that greeny shimmer. Let's make sure that it meshes nicely here. And then I'm going to put some on my other eye. After that though, I'm going to put on liner and mascara. And then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So here is the look with liner and mascara. This one is better. And that is actually because, well, the tails were a little bit thicker than I wanted originally, but okay. But here, before I kind of connected them, I looked forward and I thought, oh, well, that's fun. So I needed to replicate that on this side and I just actually got a green shimmer and pressed it on top of the eyeliner. So that side is a little bit darker than this side, but I do kind of like how it turned out. To be quite honest with you, if you want to know how I do these liners, which I call whale tails, I will leave it underneath the cards on how I do it and also in the description box. I am going to put on my falsies, which are going to be the natural ones because I think that will be fun. Yeah, I'm also going to choose a lippy and then I will be back to show you the finished look and give you my first impression on the palette and the titanium dust stuff thingy. So hold on tight because I'll be right back. So I needed to change the battery as well, so I hope I'm still in the right place. But here is the finished look. I like it. I like how it turned out. I'm glad that I chose my more natural falsies. If they look wonky, it's because they're new. And then they usually kind of sit weird. You know, you need to break them in. I thought let's pair it with a very cool toned brown, well, nude basically. This is from Sleek. It's a Matte Me in the color Stonework. And I think it went nicely with the rest. Everything else that I used on my face will be down in my description box, as it always is. But now, let's just focus on the eyeshadow palette. Let's start with the pigment. I have never worked with something like this before. So I need to make sure that I don't pack on too much. I did that on this side and I had massive amounts of fallout. So I just need to learn to work with it a little bit. Damp brush works. I can also try my mixing medium. I can try it with the NYX Glitter Primer. So I will try it on a number of different ways. And then I will give you my final thoughts in the review that I want to do about this palette and this pigment. Give you my final thoughts and tips on how to best use this. Oh yeah, before I forget, the eye pencil I have is this one from ColourPop in Electric something. Because it dropped off. It's the neony green one. The eyeshadow palette itself. I need to play with it more, obviously, but I am very much blown away by this yellow. I think the yellow is very, very nice. It showed up really nicely. I could blend it out. It sticks to the base and you can see it is still on my eyes, for which I am very grateful. This shade called Maria behaves like I thought it would, like more like a pastel, but it is a vibrant neon-y pastel. If you play with the base that you have underneath, you can also play with the color that the shade has. The base that I have now is more towards my skin tone with a little bit of hint of pink in it. I do have to say that if you put it on the eye, you shear it out because that is just the way it works. I think that if you put on a yellower base underneath, you will pull it more towards the yellow spectrum. And if you are deeper than me in skin tone, use a lighter base. Also use a tacky base and really pack the color on to get maximum color payoff. Yes, that was it. But basically, it behaves like a pastel, but it's a very nice one. So yeah, those are the shades that I worked with. This one, this shimmer, dry, wet. It's very, very pretty. Both ways. So yeah, I cannot wait to play with it more. I cannot wait to see how these two shades perform, because with her second palette, the second Hasina, I had a lot of trouble with the greens. So I'm curious to see how the formula has changed. But yeah, I really like how this look turned out. I'm very happy that I have this palette and I cannot wait to do more looks with it. So this was it for my first impression on the Layla 2 and the pigment that came with it. Let me know down below if you like the video, if you want the palette, if you have the palette, you know, all that goodness. Let's chat about it. For now, thank you so freaking much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye guys.